and of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. Welcome all of you to this Mass. Today we have Father Carlos Rojas, he's a parish father. He's already here, he's going to be the vicar of this parish. So Father Carlos, welcome. We're ready to go. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you. Thank you. brothers and sisters. The Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit Himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because He intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We just have heard the first reading, the psalm, the second reading, and the gospel. These readings are the word of God. God is speaking, and He's communicating to us His words of life. Jesus Christ used to talk, to communicate with the people in parables. And we just have heard one of the parables that Jesus uses so the people who used to follow Him understand how is the kingdom of God. And we, who are now in this 21st century, God is also speaking to us. Is the same message for all of us, that the kingdom of God is beautiful. Sometimes we think as Catholics that when we die we're gonna go to heaven. We want to go to heaven, a place with God where we can rest in peace, we can be with God and be happy. Today, Jesus Christ is telling us that the kingdom of heaven, that the kingdom of God is here on earth. The kingdom of God dwells in our hearts. That we, as Catholics, have seeds in our hearts that can grow and bear fruit and make this world a better world. Every human being on earth are born with a beautiful heart, a peaceful heart. But in our journey, when we grow up, sometimes as humans, we allow evil to be in our hearts. And every day, for some people, we find, because we don't want to do evil things, that you can do good things. If you allow God, if you allow His Spirit that dwells in our hearts, that we can be good people. We can be good citizens. We can be good neighbors. We can be good Catholics. The kingdom of God is here. Because the presence of God is here. Because we are sons and daughters of God. We belong to the same God. We have the same Father. Every time you do something beautiful to another person, the kingdom of God is there. We know that around the world there are countries that they are in war. And sometimes we desire, we want to have a peaceful earth with no wars, with no destruction. And we think that we as Christians, as Catholics, cannot do anything to change that situation. But we can. We can bring kingdom of God on earth. When we treat with respect other people, when we decide to bless instead of cursing people, when we decide to help a person in need instead of only thinking about me and about my needs, the kingdom of God dwells in our hearts. Because God has given us a good heart. And that's why we can do wonderful things to others. That's why you can be kind to other people. That's why you can help other people who are in need. That's why you can forgive other people, because you have love in your heart. That's why, because you are capable of doing something to another person who needs your help. Every day we do something beautiful to another person, the kingdom of God is there. And every day we have the opportunity to show to other people that God dwells in our hearts. We can be thankful for what we are and what we have. And I know we have more than what we need. And we can share to other people. It doesn't matter how old you are. You may say, I'm too young to do something for others. Maybe you think, I'm too old to do something to others. You may say, I'm not that intelligent. I'm not that strong. But every one of us who are here can do beautiful things to other people. It doesn't matter if you are 3 years old, 5 years old, 10 years old, 80 years old, we can always help others and make tiny things for others. And that tiny thing you do with love makes a difference. Every time we do something with love, the presence of the kingdom of God can other people see it and touch it and feel it. So I hope that today you can think about all the things, the good things that you can do for others. And do it. If you can help at home clean the dishes, you can say to your mom, to your dad, Mom, today I'm going to help you. That family will be surprised. And that is the kingdom of God. When God surprised us. Imagine your daughter or your son who never helps you to make the bed. And today when you go back home, he or she will tell your mom, don't worry, rest, I will help you. Or thank you, mom, thank you, dad, for the food that we have in our families. Thank you, mom, thank you, dad, because we can pray together, and you pray for me. And you take me to school, because I know it is important to receive an education. We can make better families. We can be better Catholics. We can be better humans. And every time we help other people, every time we treat well other people, we make our world a better world. God is with you. The Spirit of Jesus Christ dwells in your hearts. You just need to say, yes, Lord, I want to serve. I want to love. I want to give. We can make a better church. We can make a better community of Our Lady of Guadalupe here in Calexico. We can live in peace. Because the presence of God, the Spirit of God, dwells in you. May God give you wisdom so you can know how to live your life on earth. May God give you strength so you can persevere. May God increase your hope, your faith, and your love. And may God bless all of you today and always. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from God, begotten of not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for as a man before our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified on the cross of Calvary. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not come in. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We call to mind our needs and the needs of our brothers and sisters, confident that the one who searches hearts understands the groaning of the Holy Spirit within us, who intercedes on our behalf.
That the Church be a sacrament of unity, teaching us to be people of trust, rooted in faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the servant leaders of our community work to guard the quality of our environment, air and water. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we be ever mindful of the unemployed and the underemployed, and assist them with needed services and care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may greet the underprivileged and the handicapped, seeing in their faith the countenance of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we guard the sanctity of the Eucharist, always seeing it as our summit and source. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray also for the people who do evil things, who have hatred in their hearts, so that God may transform their lives and can be good people and live in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. Merciful God, you give life and love to all your children. Sown across the field of the world, may we bear fruit for your kingdom, spreading your love and grace to our sisters and brothers as you hear our fervent prayers. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will in gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of their resurrection. Jose Luis Vieira, Javier Arnson, Sergio García, Victor Reyes, Jose Malvasio, Francisco Javier Reyes, Gustavo Encarnación Moore, Socorro Gutiérrez, Manuel Rodríguez, Roberto Gutiérrez, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Pedimos por cada uno de ustedes, sus familias, sus enfermos. That with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor be yours forever and ever.
But on this day the word and my soul shall be healed. Today we are
This fire is a beautiful fire. Thank you. Thank you for the letters, for all the people who serve at this church. So thank you. And also, I'm going to do a special blessing. 2 years ago, Pope Francis established the World Day for Grandparents and the Elderly. I don't know if here we have grandparents. If you are here, I invite you, if you can, to please come here in front of the altar, before the altar, and I'm gonna bless you. So please come if you can.
Todos
abuelitos, abuelitos, grandparents, abuelitas. Vamos a bendecir a los abuelitos y a las abuelitas. We're gonna bless the grandparents. Today, the fourth Sunday of July, it is the World Day of the Grandparents, and we're going to pray for you. Because you are wise, you have experience, and you can guide other people. It's beautiful to have you here. I know that many of you, thanks to you, your children come to church. But thanks to you, they can pray, or they know how to pray. Because you have taught them to be close to God. So thank you for still coming to church. Because their grandparents, they would like to come, but they cannot. Maybe they are sick, they are on bed, and they desire to be here at church, but you are here. So feel the presence of God in your life. You have a mission, and your mission is that your grandchildren, your sons, your daughters, can see in you the presence of God. It really is, the presence of God is in your heart, in your life. I will bless you and invite the community, the rest of the community who is here, to pray for all of them so they can have a beautiful and a wonderful life. God bless these people, bless these grandparents, so they can always live in peace, and they can share your love to all people, not only to their families, but to our community of faith here in Calexico, so we can live in a beautiful, in a wonderful world. Bless them today and always, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Un aplauso a los abuelitos. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, our Mass has ended. Thanks be to God. Have a wonderful Sunday, all of you. Thank you.